Yes, guys, once again, it's your boy the H talking about those comics. That boxing and that wrestling, I might actually officially change the name, but I don't know because some people occasionally like my football and basketball patter. And I saw that word patter from a random Scottish Twitter person. I think his name's Andy. Anyway, on topic, let's get straight into it. This is why I personally think Oliver McCall and Nigel Benn's family, not just the sons, the daughters, the grandkids, whatever they have, their family need to put a stop to them coming back and fighting nonsense. Let's get straight into it. Both of them have said they want to come back. Oliver McCall's actually started the process of coming back. Let's start with Oliver McCall. So I'm just going to talk about his last two fights and his age first. I'm not going to go back into all his history, but I know for a fact he did retire. He came back out of retirement, and I believe he fought in 2014. Took a while off, but I know for a fact he's fought twice within the last calendar year. Let's get straight into that first. He fought a 27-year-old guy called Larry Knight, who I'm trying to think of the nicest word. Not even a journeyman, literally worse than a journeyman. Basically, like a I don't want to say tomato can because that's so bad, but I guess if you're losing that much and you choose to continue, I guess you can say a tomato can. I really don't like saying that, but let's just, for this argument, tomato can. This guy has won three and lost, I believe, 20. So he's won three and lost 20. He's 27. Let me give you Oliver McCall's age. Oliver McCall is only 5 years younger than my dad. My dad is 59. Oliver McCall is 54. He's 24 years older than me. He's 54 once again. I'm keep saying that, 54, guys. That is not an age for a boxer to be continuously fighting. And I know some people can talk about Foreman in his 40s and then Bernard Hopkins into the late 40s. First up, Bernard Hopkins' style is completely different. He used the actual ring, he used his boxing ability, holding, and obviously when it got to the level when he was losing to guys like, I think, was it Joe Smith? When he was losing to guys who were much lower level than he would be losing to, he bowed out gracefully. I haven't heard of Bernard Hopkins coming back. Hopefully he's retired and it's all good, but he has all his faculties. You see him doing a bit of a promotion for Golden Boy, talking on behalf of Golden Boy. He seems all good. George Foreman came out of the George Foreman grill, so I really hope he doesn't ever unretire. He is still the oldest heavyweight champion at this time. I believe he probably will keep that record till the end of time. Might be wrong, I'd be surprised. Just based on he was so durable, he had that amazing power. Was it Larry Holmes he beat to win the title again when he came back? I'm not too sure. Was it Tommy? No, I was gonna say Tommy Morrison, but no, Tommy Morrison lost to Ray Mercer, so I think he beat Holmes. I think he beat Holmes. It might have been one of the Sphinxes. Oh, I'm not too sure about that because this isn't a George Foreman interview. This is a video about Oliver McCall. So let's get straight back into it with Oliver McCall. Guy's 54. He beat a guy with a 3-win, 20-loss record named Larry Knight. Then he faced a Mexican. What was his name? Hugo Lamel. I think it's Hugo Lamel. And he's got a winning record, which is not a great winning record, 20 and 13, which means he still lost 13. This guy was 37 years of age. He fought him in Mexico this May. So Oliver McCall has fought this May. He's passed all the medicals and stuff, guys. But listen, here's what people need to understand. Passing a normal routine medical, which they are using the Texas Commission, which is a commission that actually granted him a boxing license, a Texas boxing license. They literally go into it. Basically, I read it through a sports article, was it a Bleacher Report? Bleacher Report article about Oliver McCall, I believe. And they went in depth in it, and it's just like a normal medical guide. So it basically your heart rate, they make you jog a bit, make you count, make you do a basically concussion test. I myself, you guys know this if you watch a lot of my videos, I train MMA, I've trained boxing in the past, and at the moment I train both. And I was once concussed. I wasn't knocked out or nothing, but I sparred with a guy who was about 18 stone, 6 foot 4. This was back when I was 21. I didn't go down. I've never actually been dropped. Well, I'm not trying to guess myself, I'm just being honest. But here's what was done. So I don't think we had head guards at the time. Had mouth guards, and obviously I was only fighting. I was a lot lighter than even I am now. I was fighting lightweight, so I might have been, I don't know, whatever that is, 11 stone, or I'm trying to cut down actually less to get to bantamweight, but I'm gonna walk around more. That's not the point. Point is, let's say 11 stone versus a guy that's 19, 20. And I was taking the punches, I was dodging and moving, using my southpaw stance, using my angles and all this. But obviously, I still took a few blows. And then I remember taking one massive one on my temple, and it felt bad. I was really dizzy. I was feeling sick, like I wanted to throw up afterwards. Said to my dad took me to hospital. And the doctors basically said I was concussed, and it was based on reflexes. My reflexes were slow, and it hit my knee. They got me to, they put like something in front of me. I can't remember what it was. It was like a little pen, a bit like Men in Black, move it in front of you. Basic coherence stuff. And if you're concussed immediately, you can't, or if you've got mental faculties which are not in the top percentile of what they should be, they will say you're concussed, and they'll give you some little notes and say you shouldn't do training for so long and so forth. Basically, what it looks like to me is that Oliver McCall's had that, not concussion protocol, but basically basic medical, his heart rate, his flexibility, and he's probably like still verbally coherent. He can still be quite eloquent or erudite when he talks. People looking at that and thinking, oh, Oliver McCall can still talk. He's still an interesting guy. He's an intelligent guy. None of that has got to do with the fact he has took numerous seismic blows to the head, guys. Frank Bruno and Lennox Lewis being the least of them. Literally two of the heaviest punches in the heavyweight division, probably of all time, smashed him up. You can't tell me that's healthy to come back at that age. Listen, I'm 30 and I've started back in MMA and boxing, and I'm training with guys who are 17, 18, 19, 20. Well, let's say between the ages of 17 really and 25. There's a few guys older than me as well, but majority I say between like 18 and 25. Guys, I've still got my speed. Guess what? That you can have your speed at 30. I know they say when you're 30, you lose your speed. That doesn't happen just like that. Eventually, I'm sure I will lose some of my speed, like probably 34, 35, I don't know. But you can maintain some speed, but here's the difference, their reflexes. For these young little guys, their reflexes are just that tiny, not a huge difference, but it's that tiny bit difference. Obviously, I'm not a professional, but you've got to think, 54 years of age, and he's going to want to be fighting guys like Andy Ruiz, who's in their mid to late 20s. It's not going to work out. These guys, their reflexes will be better, their speed will be better, let's be honest. Oliver McCall wasn't like the most Tyson Fury technical Usyk type boxer, so he's going to get bombs thrown at him. He's going to take the bombs. No, guys, I just don't agree with it. Oliver McCall, according to him in this Bleacher Report article, I think it was Bleacher Report, it was some kind of sport article, they put Oliver McCall to come down. But I read it a few days ago, but I thought I had to do a video. Basically, his daughters and his family saying they're supporting him. His son Elijah supporting him, all this rubbish. At the end of the day, guys, you can't be doing that. Like, my dad's 59, he's obviously not a boxer, a professional boxer, but like you just think to yourself, oh, my dad is in his 50s, even late 40s, you've got to think, like, is it a great idea? Not really. Like, if you're broke and you've got no money, I can understand it. According to him, he's making a good living, he's still earning money. His son Elijah was a boxer. Here's the dumbest thing he said. So his son Elijah lost to Andy Ruiz back in 2012 or 13. Elijah's retired now, he had a good record, 13-3 or something like that. Don't know why he retired so young. Obviously, he did 40, he might not get to the same level as his dad, didn't want to be in his shadow or whatever, that's a conjecture. But anyway, so his son lost to Andy Ruiz, and Oliver McCall literally says in his article, oh, I want to get revenge for my son. Mate, Andy Ruiz would destroy you. Literally, Daniel Dubois would destroy you. Wilder, Fury. Yeah, Fury. Honestly, I think Fury would take him out, Oliver McCall, now within a few rounds. Over top 20. Otto Wallin would probably finish him. Like, at this age, guys, I've gone back. You can find footage of some of his last few fights. There were some highlights of his fight against Knight. I don't know if it's not on YouTube. That was of a few days ago. But the highlights I've noticed have been changing, probably because of copyrights and stuff. But no, guys, Larry Knight, a guy with, was it 3 wins and 20 losses? He's 27, but on the basis of beating him and Hugo Lomel, a random Mexican journeyman you guys have never heard of, I might have even pronounced his name wrong or probably snuck it wrong. No, Oliver McCall, please don't do it. Think about your safety and your health. Nigel Benn, exact same thing. The only difference is Nigel Benn has had an even longer distance. I watched a boxing talk with Arde's video, and I believe he last fought before my brother was born. My brother was born in 1997. He's 22, my little brother. I think I heard Arde say that Nigel Benn boxed last 96. That's 23 years ago, guys. 23 years ago. I was a 7-year-old young boy getting into comics, watching a bit of boxing occasionally with my dad, and loving the England team. I think Glenn Hoddle was manager at the time. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's how long ago it was, guys. It was more than a generation. Generation spanning 20 years. More than a generation ago, Nigel. You haven't fought since. I'm sure you're in the gym training. But listen, in the gym, pads don't hit back, number one. A lot of people say it about Yard, he didn't spot. I didn't realise that was true until just before the fight. I never heard it until the fight. And then people saying, oh yeah, he didn't spot. Trust me, there's a big difference. Like, on pads, you can be a god. You can literally look like an absolute beast. But then when you're live sparring now, it's not, bros, trust me, and ladies, it's not the same. It is completely different. You're getting hit by a target. Even if these guys aren't great, you've still got to have your fitness at a certain level to move your head and be able to dodge and evade them and hit them back. Could Nigel Benn spar? Probably, at an okay level, with head guards on, with 16-ounce gloves. Do I want to see Nigel Benn, who my dad remembers watching him fight against Eubank? I don't remember those fights personally, but I've seen them on repeat and stuff. But do I really want to see those guys fight again? Especially a guy like Sakio Bika, who won the Contender Series, who, I don't know if he had held a world title, I think he has, but he definitely contended for world titles. He loves Australia, Sakio Bika, he's moved there. He also talked about his Australian wife, and he loved Australian Contender Series. Do you guys remember that? Really great show, that's a different tangent. But yeah, Sakio Bika will destroy him, easily. Everyone, I don't see him beating anyone in middleweight, super middleweight, light heavyweight. I think he's the same wants to come back as light heavyweight, which means he'll come back bigger. Yeah, he can be more bigger, be more muscly, but then he's gonna have less stamina realistically because there'll be more muscle for the oxygen to go to his body, more blood flow. Oh, this is not good, guys. This is just not good. I really don't want to see Nigel do it. I don't want to see Oliver McCall do it. These guys are legends in the game. Google them up, Wikipedia them up, BoxRec them up. They were legends in the boxing game. I personally think this is much more of a big issue than stupid KSI and Logan Paul. Let that fight happen. They're two young guys. They're not going to fully go out there to decapitate people. Like, I don't believe they are. I watched the first fight. And I'm going to watch the second fight. They're not going to. They're not dumb. They've both got brands. I wouldn't be surprised if they've done a handshake deal under the table saying, oh, we won't go 100%, we'll go 80 or 90%. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe one of them will proper KO the other one. I won't be surprised if the points win. Even if they do KO the other one, it'll be based on power, and I'm sure they'll both be fine. They're still young guys. They can recover, hopefully. But these guys, Nigel Benn has took a huge accumulation of damage in his days. The wars with Collins, the wars with Eubank. I just don't see the point of it. Like I said, Oliver McCall with Lennox Lewis and Frank Bruno, to say the least. Guys, you don't need to do it. You're already rich. Nigel, you're living in Australia and you're friends with Sakio Bika. Why would you fight him? And then if you do it like that and say, oh, they're because they're friends, it's just basically a glorified spar. There's no point in that. And then the reason people want to still watch Floyd Mayweather do his exhibitions against Tenshin and possibly one against Pacquiao is because Floyd Mayweather is still young, he's undefeated, he never took the accumulation of punches. And here's the thing I want people to really, really understand. In sparring, you're going to take more punches than you ever will in a fight, because you might spar 3, 4, 5 times a week, maybe even twice. To think about it, if you spar the full length, and usually you do more. So spar, instead of doing a 3-minute round, you might do a 5-minute round. You might do a Shark Tank with 10 other guys. So you'd be swapping opponents each round. So think about that. So the accumulation of punches is gonna take in sparring, unless you don't spar. And if you don't spar, like I said, you could, when you come against a live opponent, you might be in for a shock. Like, supposedly Yard was against Kovalev, if it's true that Yard didn't spar, I don't know. But guys, I just think it's ridiculous. I'm really not happy with that. Like, I know a lot of people going like KSI Logan Paul, but that's not even an issue. Let them. If they get the license, they're fit, they're fine. Neither of them have had, like, pardon me, any signs of multiple concussions or had to go through concussion protocols because of numerous hits, especially heavy hits to their brain. But all of them cool. And Nigel Benn, you can't tell me they both haven't had concussions. Maybe they weren't... they weren't verified as concussions back in those days because concussion protocols and CTE knowledge was nowhere near what it is now. But personally, if that's my family, all I can speak for is myself. I wouldn't let them do it at the end of the day. Like, even if I was, like, say, another 15 years older myself, like, even I want to get back to amateur fighting, yeah? Not professional, of course, but amateur level. I'd hope someone would be like, hey, I don't know about that, like, you're getting a bit old now. Like, these guys are literally 54, Oliver McCall, 55, Nigel Benn, respectively. They're only a few years younger than my dad. I know they're former ex-professionals and all this, you can say what you want. I don't think it's right to have guys of that age who could possibly receive brain damage, terrible CTE, and just, it could lead to anything in the future. I personally am really disgusted by anyone even thinking them to give them a license, any board. Hopefully neither of them get it. By saying that, I know McCall did manage to in Texas. Let's be honest, like, Texas, I'm sure you guys have heard stuff about there. But no, I think it's completely wrong. Say no, hopefully Nigel Benn doesn't get his license, and like I said, they can be happy in retirement, do something else. Guys, go on TV, be a pundit, be a commentator, write another book, whatever you've got to do. But please, guys, hang up the gloves. You're old now, you might not feel old, but you are, and it's time for you guys to be safe and put your safety and your family first instead of just like some ego boost or whatever you want to do. If it's not about money, then you don't need to do it. That's my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think. Cheers.